Hi. You might have an approval history related to your record, and you actually want to get this approval history information directly into your document. So you just want to give an overview of the approval history. Unfortunately, my Salesforce blocks the querying of approval history directly. So what we have done is actually provided you with an actionable that is just some custom component that we have built that you can just get via our support department. And then with this component, you are able to retrieve all of the approval history information, even if Salesforce does not allow the direct querying. We provide that capability directly for you. Okay, so now we want this overview in our approval history, how we go about that. First step is we of course create a .conf. In our .conf, we just give our name, all of our information. That .conf also needs a data source. This is a special data source in this case. In this case, our data source is a key value data source. So if you generate a new data source, make sure it's of type key value, and the type of the data source is list of objects. Because in your approval history, you might have multiple records, and that's why it has to be a list. Okay, now we have our data source. This data source will actually contain all of the approval history information that you see over here. Next step is we create our actionable. So after installing our custom component to retrieve approval history information, you have to indicate that you want to use this actionable on your .conf or on your pack. Both are possible. In this case, it's a .conf. So what we have done here, we have added on our .conf an actionable, and actually this actionable, if I open that one, is actually configured like this. So it's linked to our .conf. It has a specific name. The class you will find in our academy, so you can just copy paste it from there. It's of course a before because we have to get the information populated to the data source before we send it to PDF Butter. Make sure it's active. Very common mistake that people do not put their actionables active. So make sure it's active, and then you link it to the target data source. So this is the data source where you want the data to sit in. So this is all of your approval data will end up in this data source, and that's the actual data source that I've just shown earlier, the key value data source. Okay, next up we go to our .conf. So we go to our config screen and we add the approval history data overview data source. This data source will have no fields. So if you have to, so if you open up this data source, it will actually be empty. So you have to manually add the fields. Now, how are the field names? You can find that on our Academy. So you just have to click this button, Add Fields, for every field that you actually need. So in this case, I want the actor ID, and I'm actually copy pasting this from our Academy. So the actor name, and we want our comments. Make sure they are case sensitive, so don't type them, really copy them, that everything is case sensitive. And remember that the created date field is of type date. So if you set the type date, you can actually format that field in the right way. Okay, next up is we need a document, of course. So I also prepared that for this demo. It's a very simple one. So I just have a table, and I have a bunch of fields in that table, columns in which I want to show my data. So now I want to start repeating this row. That's all very basic PDF Butler stuff. So you probably know how that works. So you want to just repeat this row for every approval history record that we have. So next up is of course just creating our table row config type. We of course link it to our approval history overview data source, and all the rest is history. So we just have now this entire all of these fields that we want in our table. So you know how that goes. That's standard PDF Butter. Results? is if we run this approval history document, you click the button, the actionable will have populated the data source. The data source will have printed over here, as you can see, and all of my data that comes from the approval history list actually directly in my document. So that's it. That's how you use our approval history component.